Has your wife ever gotten mad at you for behaving wrong in her dreams? I had a horrible dream last night. You want to hear about that?
No.
I'm going to tell you anyway. You told me you've had enough of me and had fallen in love with another bitch. Where is she? She doesn't exist. Prove it. How to prove something that doesn't exist? This is China's current embarrassment. In recent weeks, a handful of U.S. media outlets and politicians have been hyping up the lab leak theory that has already been repeatedly repudiated by top virologists worldwide. But have you ever thought about where this lab leak theory came from? Wait, is it from the American movies? Such as The Hot Zone, Resident Evil, The Crazies, Race of the Planet of the Apes? Well, I'm a big fan of them, honestly speaking, whether they're based on real events or imagination. Meanwhile, the movies can fully explain the reason why some U.S. politicians incline to think of a lab incident whenever there's a virus. They watch too many movies. Or is it possible that the United States cooked up this hypothesis due to its own secret experience of previous lab leak incidents? Wow, so much we don't know. If that's the case, in psychology we call it the curse of knowledge. When they're making a judgment, they tend to be influenced by their previous knowledge or experience without realizing it. But we don't have the experience. The lab neither. Here's another thing. A new study by the U.S. National Institutes of Health suggested that the coronavirus was present in the United States as far back as in December 2019, weeks before the first cases were officially reported. Uh-oh. Similar reports also showed the coronavirus emerged in Europe earlier. Given the fact that the coronavirus broke out in several parts of the world outside Asia, shall we go and search for the lab all over the world? Save your efforts. How can we find something that exists only in the mind? Next time your wife is mad at your behavior in her dreams, here's what you're gonna do. Gently give her a hug and say, "Darling, you've watched too many movies."